It's one of them winter days when we go out, you know, it's freezing cold today, we've got an easterly wind, all the leaves are sort of coming off the trees. The last couple of weeks, the water temperature's absolutely plummeted. And these are the sort of days when, you know, I come to a fishery like I have today at the Riddings Fishery near Coventry. It's a venue that I fished a couple of times and I've so enjoyed the fishing. It's the mixed fishery. We've got skimmers, cruisins, little fantails, F1s, and also there's plenty of big carp. And then to catch these fish during the winter on a little method feeder, we've got to bring everything down. So the size of the feeders we're using, you know, a tiny little bit of bait on the feeder, shorter hook lengths, believe it or not. Some of the venues I go to, if you're allowed, if the fishery allows it, is not fish 4 inches, but fish sort of 2 and 3 inch hook lengths. And with those little tiny method feeder, it makes a big difference. And also what kit you're using, you know, little tiny hooks, the rods that we're going to be using today are probably slightly different to what I use normally. And that's for one reason. I want to get every single fish out that I hook. So it has to be nice and soft. We're not going to be casting feeders a big distance today. And like going back to the rods that I'm using, it's probably a rod that you sort of associate with natural fishing, which is a Superior SL. But make no mistake, you know, them rods are absolutely mustard at skimmer and roach fishing on natural venues, but they do a job on a commercial like I'm fishing today. So I'm itching to get fishing. Let's get back and I'll run you through everything, what we're going to be doing at the Riddings Fishery today. We got a little tiny stocky F1, look at that. You see the little tiny ICM, little method I got on there. And on the day, it can be absolutely deadly. Just started on a single maggot. I've actually banded the maggot at the moment because I can go from like little bandoms. But the water temperature is so cold, them fish are absolutely freezing. So I'll just show you. But I'm fishing with a 10-foot SL. Like I said, a little ICM. Little flat method, one of the tiniest little methods we do. It's got its own mold, and just putting a little bit of ground bait around it at the moment, just to try and get a little bit of bait in me peg, make a little bit of a cloud. It's a 25 gram feeder, so I get it out there. Look at that, like a little morsel of ground bait on there. Absolutely ideal for what we're trying to be catching today. I've got me little pellet feeder there ready as well. I've done some 2 mil pellets up, but I just thought with it being so cold, I could just start on that little feeder. It's quite deep, this lake. It's probably like 7 foot, 8 foot deep. And that's what this little film's going to be about. I'm still fishing with 6 pound main line. That's not a problem. But I brought my hook length down to 0.15. And believe it or not, sometimes when I'm fishing for Crassio, I even fish 0.11 power line. I have got some hook lengths done with 0.11 on. And when I go to certain venues with these little tiny feeders like I'm using today, you can go down to 0.11, a size 18, you know, GPM or 16 GPM. And you'll be amazed the difference it makes. But having the right rod, a nice soft rod like an SL, makes a huge difference. I mean, they are designed to actually take all the actual, sort of not the fighting out of the fish, but everything's just, it doesn't never sort of bottom out, which is what you want at this time of year. Even if I hook a big carp today, that rod will be perfectly fine with it. I've got a 0.75 tip in. Obviously, I'm not fishing with braid. I'm fishing with mono, 6 pound mono, straight through to a size 18 KKMB at the moment, because I can go from sort of little pellets, little baby bandoms, single maggot. I'm just going to try and build the swim up at the moment, but it's nice to get a couple of quick bites to sort of get us going. But it's lovely fishing, you know, just building it up. I still think I'm going to have to be casting in quite often, even though the water temperature has gone down a lot over the last week or two. These little fish, you know, these little fish that might be in your peg at the start. It's no different to a pole. Ooh, there was a little indication then. I thought that was going to go then. There's the actual mould for the ICM. And it is an ICM, not an ICS. So the ICM is basically interchangeable mini. So they come with their own little method, their own little pellet feeder. There's the little pellet feeder that I'm going to be putting on. So it just takes a small amount of 2 mils. You can put a little bit of ground bait in there as well if you want. But normally when I fish with a pellet feeder, it's just normal. I just put 2 mils in it. I just thought I'd start on a little tiny ground bait feeder. I know there's all sorts of different fish in here. And that normally gets them going. Little tiny indication and it's spun round, so it's nice. Just starting to get a few little indications now, even though it is really, really cold. But that rod is amazing. It is, you know, I think everybody associates an SL with sort of natural waters, but when you come on a venue such as Riddings and you're catching everything, everything counts. It don't get better. It just, you know, it gives you the control of the fish, but the added bonus of fishing with little hooks, lighter lines, the pressure's on the fish, but it's just the sort of shock absorber effect. It's amazing. And I remember getting involved, look at that. I think they are actually little crassios, I'm not too sure. They're like a little hybrid-y thing. I think they are little crassios, really. Loads of them venues nowadays got these little crassios in, and they, you know, they are an absolute nightmare to stay on the hook. But using the right hook, everything, sort of the right combination of the rod, the hooks, little feeders. So just got to get a maggot again. I might start hooking the maggot in a minute, but I'll just keep banding it at the moment. Just got a small band on. Just push the maggot's head through the band and then just halfway, just push it halfway. You can use a pellet bander on that if you want, but normally I can just get the head of the maggot through and get out of it and then just push it through. And that's the first actual maggot I've had come off. I've had like 10 casts, caught a few fish. And the amazing thing is, with a banded maggot, it's the same with a banded caster, they never really wreck the bait. It's ever so strange. I don't do like loads and loads of banded maggot fishing, only when I'm fishing for F1 shallow normally, or a little bit of feeder fishing. I can't really remember the last time I've actually unhooked a fish and the maggot's actually sucked. I'm probably chucking like 20 odd metres, maybe 25 metres, something like that. Quite deep. It's a little bit of pressure on it. Oh, look at that. Oh, yes. Don't get better. Bit of proper winter feeder fishing like that, and you can see that rod working, absolutely amazing. It's a nice fish just jumped then. Hopefully as the session goes on we might hook a sort of slightly bigger carp. I'm not sure what this is. Just keep winding a little bit. And that's the art of it, having the right rod. Keep winding. This is the crucial part, is when you've got them just off your keep net. They're nodding around. Little baby, I think that's a little stocky carp, that. Look at him. Mint condition, freezing cold. He's nipped me maggot, but I'm not fussed about that. It's just nice to get some bites. So I'm not gonna change anything at the moment. I was thinking about putting a pellet feeder on, but I think I'll stick with this little ground bait ICM feeder at the moment. New maggot on. Just feed him through. So just half filling the mould, bait in the middle. Nice squeeze. Hit the clip, down it goes. Nice to fish a lake with a little bit of depth as well. Just get that line down. Just warming up a bit now that sun's come out. Just a tiny little bend in the tip, because I'm fishing a 0.75 tip. Just got a little bit of tension on it. Not fishing elasticated stems today, just in line. Ooh, that looks a big liner, that was. Oh, hello. Oh, yeah. That was a right weird bite. Not sure what this is. This might be a skimmer, this. I'm not going to take your back wind off for that. Just keep winding. Little skimmer, I think. This is nice. And they can be really crafty some days on the pole and the feeder. Little 8-ounce skimmer. Maggot's still on. That combination, that little feeder, lovely soft rod. Don't get better for winter feeder fishing. It's still got the backbone. To actually chuck that little feeder out, no problem at all. Nice now, because it feels like you've been casting in and out 20 to sort of 30 minutes, got a little bit of bait in the area. Obviously I've got my options there, a little mini bandoms, I've got a few robin reds, little 4mm and 6mm robin red pellets, I've got my normal commercial sort of pellets, you know, natural colour pellets. Oh, yes. Oh, can't believe I missed that. I bet that was a skimmer. Even though it was a real fierce bite, I bet it was a skimmer. It's very similar to the last bite I had. Just check the maggots in the middle of the band, which it is. I'm just sort of messing around a little bit, loading up the mould slightly different. Sometimes I'll fill it up and then put the bait in. Other times I want the maggot sort of on the top of the feeder, so I'll put it in before I put any ground bait on. But normally for me, it's sort of half fill it. If you sort of half fill it, put your bait in, and then fill it up, put your feeder in, you normally can't go far wrong with that. I've just snagged up on the inside then. See, there's a little bit of ground bait left in that feeder, even though it's a little sort of 50 pence, what I call a little, it's a sort of a size of a 50 pence piece. But if you get your ground bait right, it still binds in that little feeder. Really, really nice. Slightly better one on here now. I'm not sure what it is. Might be a bigger F1 or a carp. It's really starting to get going now, which is lovely in this weather. Oh, hello. Beautiful playing them on them rods though. Until you actually pick one up and fish with it, you really don't appreciate what it's actually like when you're fishing with smaller hooks. Little carp, I think that. Little Riddings carp. Lovely. Probably a bit of a bonus today, that one. Absolutely screamed the old tip round that. Still got his maggot. I think I can use that maggot again if I'm careful. Yes. Beautiful. Can't wait to get back in. I love this sort of fishing though. Little feeders. This time of year, a little bit colder. Everything's starting to sort of slow down. Get that maggot back in the middle again. Definitely just half-filling it, putting your hook bait in. Plenty of ground bait over the top. And you end up with that little disc like that, a pear shape. Give it a nice squeeze, because we are fishing sort of probably 8 foot of water. It's a clip, just follow it a little bit. It's a down. Get that line down. Even though that water has gone cold, the bites are still coming pretty quickly, really. Most bites are coming like 2 minutes, 3 minutes. Oh, look at that. I was just about to adjust. Just about to adjust my stopwatch and the tips crank round. Sort of shot off and then come straight at me, that. Not sure what that is. Little carp again, I think. It's lovely to catch these little carp. Yeah, look where he's hooked. You get a lot of that with stocky carp. You just hooked yourself right in the bottom of the chin. beautiful, stunning fish, eh? Got to get a maggot back on now. I think when you're sort of air rigging maggots with a band, you can use like live maggots or dead maggots. Live maggots is a bit easier to get on if you haven't got a, if you're trying to actually poke the head of the maggot through the band, which is what I'm doing. Always like making it a little bit harder for myself. Just make sure all your hair and that's. So you can't really use, that's why a lot of my bands, if I'm doing this sort of fishing, if I actually tie the hooks myself, I always use a small band, because if you want to put a 4mm pellet on, I might try a pellet again in a minute, but maggot seems to be really, really good. I've got the thickest maggots in town, they're huge maggots. The only problem is, I think I've lent my pellet bander to someone, and I've not had it back, and I've obviously forgot to put it a new one in my box. I'm not sure how many times I've actually done that since I've been fishing. Lent bait bands, I've lent all sorts of things. And if anybody's watching who's got it, I could do with it back. This is when you actually need. Yes, look at that, absolutely perfect. Fill that mould up, put plenty of ground bait over the top, sort of overfilling it really, and you've got enough bait on there then to give it a squeeze. They're right on that now, you know, we've been fishing for like an hour now and they're definitely starting to have it. Just let that go down. Probably a count of two, you know, two or three before it hits the bottom. That just shows you how deep it is. It's a little tweak. Obviously, not too much pressure. You don't want the feeder moving across the bottom or anything like that. Let me stop, watch again. Not had no big skimmers yet, though. I've had a few little ones, like eight ounces. But I think if those F1s and stockies are feeding today, I think the skimmers will struggle to get into the peg, to be honest. No bubbles or anything like that coming up. I mean, when we get into the winter months, now and again, you might get an odd little bubble. I think the bottom's not too soft where I'm fishing. Feels quite firm. I've not sort of come back with any black bits on my feeder or on my hook length. So I think I'm fishing on quite nice bottom. And never be afraid, you know, if you go out in the winter, never be afraid to have two lines going, especially if you've set your sort of day around feeder fishing. Sometimes I'll have two lines even open the water. So I'll cast slightly to my left, and then you can cast slightly to your right. And some days, going between the two, especially on a water with F1s in it especially, you can keep the bites coming. One line normally better than the other, I'm not sure why, but if you want to rest it, then if you just keep the odd cast going on the other line, you can nick a few more fish. Just get me mould ready for the next cast. Wind's getting a bit nasty now. So that's been out here 2:30. I think I'll have another cast because most of my bites have been coming really quick. It's actually, I think there's a little fish hanging on the end of there. I've never had a bite. Either that or it's fouled hooked. I don't get that sort of luck in matches, I'll tell you. Oh, look at that. It's a skimmer. It's actually hooked in the spine. Or in the dorsal. So I reckon that was literally hanging around by my feeder. I don't get that luck in matches very often, Zolt, do I? No, he's nodding his head. Little baby 4-ounce skimmer. I reckon that must have been literally right round by my hook. Let's get that slime off.
I'm just going to keep going at this. Can't really see the point in changing anything that I'm doing because I've had that nice little run, a couple of bonus sort of 2.5 pound carp, some nice F1s, some little sort of goldy sort of F1s. Lovely fishing, to be fair. It's nice. You just don't know what you're going to hook next. Just get that line down because that wind's got nasty now. That's the lovely thing with 6 pound as well. You can get that line down so much quicker than 8 pound. Especially when you're fishing with little feeders like I am today. Oh yeah, there we go. Another little tiny fish this, I think. So how fast was that? Literally had enough time to pick my stopwatch up. Another little skimmer. Look at that on a little method feeder. But they're lovely fish. Swing them out on that little rod. Probably 7 or 8 ounces. Nice fish, you know. Just adjust that maggot. That maggot hasn't been touched. It's amazing when you actually, like I said, going back a bit, that you can actually like catch that many fish. I bet you if I'd have been hooking that maggot normally, that would have been sucked. I've had to have changed it. It's actually quite nice for me to try that. It's not the sort of thing that I do day in, day out. Get a little bit of tension on. Use the rod under the water to sink the line. On your butt rest, everything's bang on. Tiny little bit of tension. Nice to catch them little skimmers as well, because they're really, I've go to some venues, you try and catch them on a little cage feeder, they can be an absolute pain to catch, honestly. You get Barston example, Barston Lakes, as we all know, God almighty, they can be so tricky to catch. And that's where these little methods can come in on their own. There we go. Not sure what that is. Look at that rod. Just cannot feel nothing this end. It's like you're winding in nothing. That's how good they are. Another skimmer. Look at that. Let's get the slime off. Little bit of ground bait left in the feeder. That's how good them feeders are. Always love coming back with a little bit of ground bait. No matter what method I'm fishing with, I always like coming back with just a little bit of ground bait left in it. It gives me the confidence then that I'm actually moulding it right. My ground bait's nice. I can bind it on. So if you see me cast, I just hold the rod just back, sort of upright from my body, and then just as I'm going to hit the clip, I then try and follow the feeder in to try and stop that sort of, oh, that line went then. Oh, it's come off. Not sure what that was. Might have been a little baby stock. It was a proper bite. The line all went tight. That's the first fish I've lost. But you can see there, a little bit of ground bait left in it. I just pick that out of my thumbnail. Because I don't want it too wet. I don't want the moisture. That's actually, I've actually hooked the maggot as well as air rigging the maggot there. That's why that's come off. I've actually double hooked the sort of maggot, if you like. So I'm just watching that line. That line actually just went, as it was coming together to sink, it just went really quickly. The way this is going, I'm not going to be using a stopwatch. It's getting going proper now. Stopwatch ain't very happy about something. A little stocky, I think, that. That's how that rod's so good at, you know, you get a little stocky on like that. Just takes all of the pressure off the hook. That's like a cruising. Look at that. A chunky little crewy thing. Great fishing. I love it. I love catching all sorts of different fish like that on a little feeder. Same maggot. Starting to get going now. I've put my ground bait actually through one of the smallest Preston riddles, the green one. I've put it through twice. I think I do that a lot, whether I'm fishing for skimmers on the pole or whether I'm fishing the mephra. I think it just makes it so much nicer. Just makes it nice and fluffy. Takes a little bit of time to push it through, but the actual end bait, I think is worth that sort of extra 10 minutes. Look at that, absolutely straight round. Really aggressive bite that was. I've had all sorts of different bites today. Little tiny dinks like that, it's like it's on, it's just sort of hooked itself. So let's talk about how the sort of day's gone really before I finish up. It's probably took like 20 minutes to start catching. That's a better fish. And then I've tried a few different things. I've tried the pellet feeder with pellets. I've tried this little method, the ICM method with ground bait and pellet. But one thing's for certain, today has been an out and out ground bait and maggot job. It's felt like they're in your peg, they're on your feeder, but if you put anything else apart from a maggot on, the fishing's just too slow. I've caught all sorts of fish here at Riddings Fishery today. I've caught F1s like this. They're sort of like a hybrid sort of F1 Carassio. They're awesome little fish. I've caught tench, goldfish, skimmers. Let's get him back. But there's one thing for sure. The best hook bait today has been a live maggot on that little hare. 100%. I bloody enjoyed it, I must admit. It's been brilliant fishing. But the highlight for me has to be this rod. I mean, I think we've lost two fish today. And one of them fish was actually where the hook had actually hooked the maggot from the hare. And I've lost one where I've actually picked up and it was on for a split second and come off. And that, you know, that's what this fishing's about. It's hooking the fish, getting them out. I've had fish up to sort of 2-2.5 pounds. We've not hooked any big fish. It doesn't surprise me with the water temperature dropped as it is. I still want to meet the person who's nicked my pellet bander. I think I know who it is. And I'm going to have to put one back in my box when I get home. be honest, you've not even, I've caught a load of fish. And we've only changed the maggot probably 10 times all day. And not one of the maggots has actually been sucked, even with the skimmers. It's crazy. So just getting that herring maggot on there. It's something worth trying for you guys when you do go fishing in the winter time. Smaller hooks, 18 kkm, and even a 20 kkm. And like I said, get your hook lengths down as well. I know you're always thinking, well, if I do hook a big fish, but I ain't being funny. Even when I fished like 011 power line, I've hooked some great big carp and I've always got them out. If you fish a nice soft rod like I'm using, you shouldn't have a problem. And the fishing's just got better and better and better. Still got a cast. Most casts I'm coming back with a fish, but there's the odd cast where I leave it there like 3 minutes and I'll have to wind back in again because it's sort of, you've missed your opportunity. But ground bait, just neat ground bait, bit of Pro Thatcher's green and match method mix, 50-50 mix, push through that small riddle twice. It just makes for a fantastic fishing. There we go, straight away again. You just don't know what you're going to hook next. But with that soft little rod, it doesn't matter. Oh, that's a real small little, what is that? That's a small skimmer, look at that. That's the smallest fish I've had today. It doesn't matter. That's what this is all about. So I'm going to see if I can get one more, hopefully a bigger one than that, to finish off. Got a little bit of fluoro lava rocks in me mix. So you get that odd little bit of fleck in there. I do that a lot and I think it's really important, especially when you're fishing like bright hook baits, even like a single red maggot. Just gives it that little bit of brightness in it. We all know how important that is on the right day. £6 main line, it makes everything so much quicker to get your line down. Like that. And like I said, the pellet feeder, went onto the pellet feeder. Nothing, literally, just like, it's like chalk and cheese. Just pointless even fishing it today. Pure ground bait, single red maggot. And you might be asking like, Des, why don't you use a 16 hook? I've done a lot of this style fishing in the past. And I've always found like an 18 kkm or even a 20 kkm. I'm not sure why, whether it's because of the size. It helps the fish, you know, using the right rod as well, using the right weight feeder, but using a small hook, personally for me, I just get loads and loads more fish out. A little indication just then. There we go, look at that. Awesome fishing. Every time I come to this fishery, I've had a brilliant day's fishing. I've only ever fished it in the winter on the pole. I've had a few fish on a little ground bait feeder one day, but it was a silverfish match. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna get this one in because we've both got a home to go to, even though I probably will stay on for a little bit, but Zolt's got a long journey. That's what this rod is all about. Look at that. It can nod its way. Little hooks. It doesn't matter. That's a little baby carp, I think. It's been mega, mega days fishing. Look at that to finish this little session off. One of Riddings' little stocky common carp. I hope you've enjoyed the film. I've certainly enjoyed the fishing today. It's been absolutely brilliant, even though my fingers are really, really cold. I'm starting to get a bit of a shiver on. I'm going to get this one back and thanks for watching.